try to answer some comments, some questions. I'm still have a flu. Actually, not have a flu. I'm just only. I feel good. Yeah, forget it. Okay. Let's start from here. How long does it take to remove the whole engine from the car? This, let us say on a C63, doesn't matter if it's 2008 or if it's 2014, it's variable. I mean, 2 years ago I made it almost 4 hours alone. Now we are doing it, I'm giving to the guys, I'm helping them also sometimes. There are 5 to 6 hours to put it down. Plus, you have where the cams. Most of them, all of them. I don't know if it has something to do with the warm climate, with the warm weather here. Of course, accelerated wear, sensor, longer factor internal. All of them on 5.6 sensors that I have opened from more than 140,000 to 150,000 kilometers, just on the covers, all of them, all the camshafts, they have wear. So I hope you feel better soon. Thank you very much, man. Thank you. This looks really easy. It is easy. It's not something complicated. I've problem with my American company. Sell money. This by mail, if you want. I'm not sure about the bench on it. If has bench on it. It's big difference. The 2 kilos, 2 kg. It's we are talking about the crankshaft. It's big difference. Even 500 grams, it's big difference. Thank you. Yes. Yeah, I stopped smoking. I'm not smoking anymore. Don't worry. So this is the 1 second. To see if I can find something else that I forget. Let me pause it and I'm gonna continue. 1 second if I found anything. Okay. This one I already answered, I think. What's the problem with this kit? 1 second to focus on the pistons and the connectors. Hey, you're not gonna find it in the United States, this pistol, this one here. These and these are the pistols. We have available in stock MO56, MO57, M275 for the V12. And we have also oversized for the V12. If you put the iron sleeve, if you sleeve the engine block for the V12. We have for Golf MK6, MK7, 82.5 and 83 millimeters with the connecting rods. For 5 cylinders, let's say Audi. M113K 55s. Yeah. Actually, this is like the old school forged pistons. It's not hyperactic, hyper. I don't know how it's called that in English, I don't know how it's spelling even. That's expanding, and after 20,000 kilometers start coming wear everywhere, like this. I don't wanna say which brand it's. These pistons, you saw it before. These here are the stock pistons MO57 from here to here. I have only one set of MO13K, and this is because there was one mistake. The ice tank was empty, we didn't put coolant inside, I wasn't here. And he came the customer, he wanted to drive the car, and one guy that he was working here, he gave him the car without coolant inside. He didn't say anything to anybody. He pushed the customer the car and he melted the piston over there without coolant inside of the ice tank. That's why it melted the stock piston. Otherwise, we'll not have any piston from 113 gear. So M157 here, this is M156. You can see that it was rattling. This was have only 2,000 or 3,000 kilometers. You can hear that it's rattling when you start the car, when it's cold. And also that one over there, also this one over here, this is M157, aftermarket piece of connectors, M156. And actually the rest we're giving back to the customer. Even this, I know exactly to who customer belongs this one. If he comes, I can give it to him. It's just only, it takes space for me here. I don't know where to put it. So I have everything here. What else? Yeah, we are not using this piston from that company. We are using our pistons. It's with our specs. Then there is another one comment that I was thinking about that long time ago. Then with the time I forget it. 1 second. Just 1 second. This one. Yeah, you are right on that. I think you need to work on bulletproofing the valve train and camshafts. You are right on this. You're absolutely right. But the point is, I have to find one cylinder head that's it's for scrap. That means has too much problem and I cannot repair it. I cannot use it anywhere because to destroy a good healthy cylinder head, it's I'm not gonna do it, you know. And I don't think so that somebody wants to pay to destroy a new cylinder head, a healthy cylinder head. So my target is in the future, if I can make it, if I can find any destroyed cylinder head, don't worry, come, man, I'm talking to the camera. So what? My target is to put everything, put the camshafts, even old camshafts, old pocket valves, fix a path for the oil, put a plexiglass cover here up, put it on 45 degrees, the angle, the cylinder head, and start giving power to this gear, spinning the camshafts, and at the same time to put one electric oil pump and pushing oil, all this at 45 degrees. And to can be variable, let us say, to work at 3000 RPMs, work on idle, to see what's going on, how it's lubricating the camshaft, and how I can modify the cylinder head, how much allowed me the cover, I can modify, let us say, the cylinder head, so to put a jet or to put, let us say, something, to do something. This first I have to do that one to see how it's lubricating the camshafts, the lobes, and then to see later on what kind of modification you can make on that. Yeah, that's it. Thank you very much. I'm with you now. I forget. Yes, there is... I have to continue. Somebody sent me email message, I don't remember what. It's asking how to... for the BMW N63. Somebody said to him that there is he has a problem with the connector bearings or wrist pin. He has a sound from the bottom of the engine. What can you do to see if there is a problem with the connector bearings on the wrist pin? If you have diagnostic tool, you can start and turning off the ignition one by one in the cylinder, and you can hear if it stopped making the sound, because when it's making explosion inside of the combustion chamber and it's pushing down the piston, you hear the space that has the bearing from the connector or the wrist pin. So by just turning off one by one the cylinders, you can see which cylinder has a problem and if it is wrist pin or connector bearing. If you don't have diagnostic tool, very simple and very careful. Well, but actually it's not careful. On the BMW you can just only remove the plug from the coil. You're gonna open one coil you're gonna open the safe on one coil on the BMW on the N63, you're gonna pull out the plug. You'll accelerate it a little bit slowly, not high RPMs, to hear the sound. If the sound disappears, that means this what you unplug, it's that cylinder that has a problem. If you unplug all of them and it's continuously the sound, either you have in the two cylinders bearings that's melt, it's not only one, or it's something different. keep in your mind that on the bottom end there is also the timing, there is a chain for the oil pump, and there are also guides there, and if one guide fail, let us say burn and crack and fail, it can produce some sound. What do you want? Tell me. Not to call you. Just so don't blow to make the video. 1 minute. That's it. Thank you. What else? Oh. Now I was going to say another thing and I forget it. Ah, yes. One friend, he sent me message. He sent me email. He want to swap on a G-Class short wheel bass. He's planning to swap either to put the M157 engine or to put M113K. That means to convert it on the G55 or G63. If you want my opinion, if you don't want to have any headache or something, it's better to find, let us say, it's much better to find one G55 accident car, let us say side accident or rear accident, to get for a good price, strip off both cars and swap all the parts from one car to the other. And whatever it's broken, let us say you have it deployed, let us say one airbag, you can purchase just only one airbag extra, one used airbag, or if there is any panel problem, let's say one bumper or something, because different shape than yours, you can get only the bumper. But the main thing is that you need the wiring harness, the PCM, the electrical part of the car. So, and on the G-Class plug and play, because you are talking about G-Class and G-Class, so you're not going to face any issue. The battery location, everything is a little bit weird on the G-Class, also for the transfer case. And it's much better to find one accident in good price and swap all of the parts, all of everything. It's going to take you approximately 1 week to make all the swap, to strip off the car and dress it with the parts that you're going to get from the other car. The same thing it's also for the G63, for M157 engine. The bi-turbo, it's much better because you have different fuel system, you have too many things. Much better to find one accident car, even if it's G63 or G55, get all the parts and dress your car, and whatever is remaining, go back to the same guy that you purchased the accident car and tell him, habibi, this is what I have, you can get it back, how much you give me to get some money. Now if you get, let's say, one engine, one M113K engine with a supercharger, and then you try to put it, and then you need to have, let us say, you need also the wiring of the engine, and then you have to fix the ECU because you have to control also the bypass throttle, because there is electrical throttle. It's a little bit difficult. Not difficult, you can make it, but at the end of the day you're gonna missing parts. Actually the engine sits in different way if you have a 6-inline engine, or if you have, let's say, the V6. It's different the shaft that's merging the transmission with the transfer case. It's different the length. The transmission is different, the clutches actually. You have 722.6, but the clutches insides are different. If you have a V6 and the V8, the M13K. So the best solution, if you want my opinion, find one accident car and swap it. Make it a good and clean job. I don't know when you're gonna make it, where. Not when, sorry, where you're gonna make it, it's up to you this one. Just make sure, make a clean up, let us say strip off your car completely, paint it when need to be paint before you install the things, put insulation when need to be insulated the car, dress it nice and properly, be prepared and have some clips with you for the wiring, find some clips, aftermarket usually, because from Mercedes they're not giving you the clips. So to replace some clips or something, to route perfect wiring inside as it is from the factory. Then dress the carpet, clean the carpet, wash the carpet, dress it again, back again as it was, as it is, and start making, building the car from inside to outside. Keep in your mind, the engine, the transmission is the last one that you have to put inside. First you have to prepare all the rest. This is my opinion about the swap on the G-Class. And keeping in mind that if it's a short wheel base, it's maybe no need any modification. No. So the point is, don't be from short to long. Yeah, there are a couple of things you have to take care about it. Maybe let us say the sizes are the same, the panels are the same. Yeah. I haven't done on the G class, but I don't think so. It will be complicated, not complicated. You're gonna be a bit headache because think about it, you have to remove also the dashboard, you have to remove too many things. I have done this before on the Mustang. I have made it on the Mustang from 4.6 normal with a single overhead cam, and I converted to Shelby GT500. I make all the swap, it took me 3 days, but it's a Mustang, it's not a Mercedes. It's much more easy. That's it, yeah, finally, another one big video. Thank you very much.